Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Simply Sadie. I wanted to do a baking and review video for you guys. I recently, I think within the last 2 weeks, I found this cast iron skillet sugar cookie baking set at a nearby store, and I thought it was super cute, and I thought it would make a great video idea. So it comes with the skillet, which surprisingly enough, I'm not a huge fan of cast iron skillets. I know I'm gonna get a lot of hate for that, it's just me. I just thought that this would be such a cute idea to do, and it's it was only a few dollars. And it says that the cookie mix is included, and it says on the back that I have to clean the skillet with water and soap before baking. Rinse and dry off, lightly coat the skillet with vegetable oil and wipe off with paper towel. Wipe down the skillet with vegetable oil again after use. So basically the same cleaning and seasoning as you would with a normal cast iron skillet. I only know that because of my dad. I will link his channel in the description box. He has a barbecue channel and he uses a lot of cast iron skillets for his cooking. For this, it says you will need 1.5 tablespoons of softened unsalted butter, but I'm actually gonna switch that and I'm gonna use coconut oil instead. 1 egg yolk and 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil. I might have to switch the vegetable oil out for avocado oil or olive oil if I have those. And it says preheat oven to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. Empty cookie mix into mixing bowl and add the butter and the egg, which I am just going to be using this small little bowl since it's such a small little cookie. That should be fine. Mix until completely blended. Use vegetable oil to coat the bottom and sides of the skillet. Scoop the dough into skillet and spread evenly. Bake for 12 to 14 minutes. Remove skillet from the oven using an oven mitt. Be careful because the handle is very hot. Serve as is or add your favorite toppings. So I am going to go ahead and get what we need for this, and then we will start mixing it. But first impressions, I think that this is such a cute idea. I think it's so cute that it has like the mix is included, and it's such a self-serve cookie thing. And I just think it is absolutely adorable. The only thing that I wish is that it came with more cookie mix. But so far, that's the only thing I wish that was different. All the rest of it I love, and it's so adorable. So I'm going to open this, and we'll see what is inside and how it looks. So. So, on the inside of the packaging, the skillet with the cookie mix came in a little plastic box like this. It was inside the box. And then on the inside, it's so cute. On the inside, it has this little card that says, "Thank you for your purchase." And then on the inside has like a sweepstakes thing, but that's it that's in the box. So I'm going to open this. Ooh, my goodness. I showed this to my mom before filming this and she thought it was so cute and she was telling me that if they still have it at the place that I went to, that I should get more because it would be so cute for making individual little things of like breads and stuff like that, and I think that would be a great idea. And like maybe even a little self-serve cake. I honestly have been so excited to use this, but I realized that once I use it, I will eat the cookie in like 15 minutes. And that I want it to last, so I have been stalling on making this video because I only had one. Alright, so I am going to wash this off just how you would any normal cast iron skillet. It does feel a little bit different from the cast iron skillets I have at my house. It feels a little bit more rough and grainy, but maybe it just needs to be seasoned and washed. So I will do that. I will be right back and then we will get started with the baking portion. Alright, so I am back. I have washed this with soap and water, and now I'm going to add a little bit of olive oil to the pan to kind of season it. I'm just adding a very small amount because this is a very small pan. Alright, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to start with the mixture. So, this is... Alright, so another first impression. I noticed that the cookie on here had sprinkles. I don't know if you guys can see that. But it has, like, colorful sprinkles on it. But it doesn't look like there are sprinkles in the mix. Maybe there are and I just can't see them yet. Well, that went everywhere. Alright, so word of advice. Use scissors and cut across the top rather than ripping it, because it'll get everywhere. All right, so I have the little mixture in here, and then I have to add 1.5 tablespoons of soft unsalted butter, which I'm just going to use organic refined coconut oil. All right, so that is probably good. All right, so 1 egg yolk, and I have a separate bowl here to catch the remnants of it. All right, so 1 egg yolk. There we go. And then 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil. So I am just going to use olive oil. I'm gonna wash my hands really quick here. All right, I am back, so I need to put 1 teaspoon of vegetable oil, which is olive oil for me. Alright, so I'm still not noticing as I'm mixing this any sort of sprinkles. So I'm kind of sad about that. I don't know if it was just one of the variations of the cookies that this company does, or if they just decided to put that type of a cookie picture on there. But I am a tad bit disappointed that it doesn't have the sprinkles on it. Alright, so this is the mixture so far. I'm going to put the cookie mixture. So I'm going to turn on the oven, and once it's heated, I will put this in the oven, and then I will come back when it's all cooked. So it says to preheat oven to 350 and then bake for 12 to 14 minutes. Alright, so I will. And I will catch you guys once it's finished. Alright, you guys, it just came out of the oven. I looked at it at about 12 minutes and it was still kind of like jiggling in the center. So I decided to just leave it in for another 2 minutes. And this is what it looks like. Looks like that. The sides look like that. It looks like something I feel like that you would get at like TGI Fridays. It's good though. So I love the packaging. It's super cute. I love how everything just came in the set. I do wish that it came with like one extra, at least one extra pack of the mix, because that way you can have the exact amount, but at the same time I understand that you can also just find a recipe online and just use that, so I get that. Also, one thing I didn't like was how the packaging made it look like it had sprinkles on it, but there's no sprinkles. So, I don't know if it was just something that was like, you can add sprinkles if you want to, but I thought it was actually gonna be like a sprinkle cookie, or have like a pack of sprinkles on it. So overall, I would give this an A, not an A plus, but an A, because it's super cute. I love the packaging, I love the idea of this, but I just wish that it had like everything that was pictured, like the sprinkles, and then maybe like one extra pack of the mix. But again, I know that you can just find a recipe online and use it. So I'm gonna try this piece that fell off the side. Okay. It's really good. So this is really good. It tastes really good. The packaging is super cute. Reminds me of something from like TGI Fridays or Applebee's or something like that. Like how they serve it to you, like in a cast iron skillet type of thing. So overall, I like this product. I would recommend that you go out and get it, and I'm going to eat this now. So thank you guys for watching this video. If you have tried out this product, let me know what you think about it down below, or let me know if you would want to try it out. Let me know if there's anything in this review that I didn't talk about that you would have liked to hear. I will try to make it a point for the next item that I do a review on, to make sure that I touch on those subjects that you guys kind of tell me about. So anyway, let me know what you want to see next for me to do a review on, and what you would want me to point out in that review, and let me know if you've tried this product down below. And I'm gonna go eat this now. So thank you guys for watching. Thank you for subscribing and liking my videos. And I will talk to you in my next one. Bye.